going on YouTube? It's your boy Vince, and today we are back with another reaction. Today we're reacting to Inside the Indiana Reservation, where people go missing?
Huh?
Tommy, who do you think you are? You are not Detective Conan. There are no leads for you out there. You will find no clues, no nothing. Why would you do this? No! No! The only thing you may find out there is yourself missing. Yeah, clearly, if people are going missing around this area, something's bad out there, and he's looking for you too. It ain't no exception because you got a camera out talking about, we got you on camera. He's still gonna snatch you up and take you. That is not smart. This is how he thought it was gonna go.
Oh!
Alright guys, Detective G here. We've been on the move for about 5 hours. It's currently 3 a.m. scary hour. And we finally reached the ancient burial ground where multiple people have been known to go missing. And I'm here to do some investigation to find out what's been causing this. I'm here with just me and my cameraman. We're just two guys lonely and we have to get this done. Let's go. Yo, wait. You guys hear that? Right there. Is that a Bigfoot? Oh. Hey, Bigfoot, is that you? Come on, bro. I don't need to do no investigation to put two and two together. People go missing. Something bad is taking them. You know what I'm saying? That's my investigation right there. I'm out of there. So we finna get into this video and see Inside the Indiana Reservation Where People Go Missing by Tommy G. So let's get into it. Let's go.
A lot of murders that haven't been solved. A lot of people have been out here and they never find anybody who did it.
I would be moving. I wouldn't be living here.
By our count, it is the 28th time this year. We know the FBI is also involved in this case since it's on Gila River Indian Community land.
Oh, who Tommy editor? He be killing the edits.
For white boys like me, native reservations are hard places to access, and understandably so. Because I understand history, it makes sense why Native Americans can be closed off, resentful, and even downright hostile towards white folks.
Yep, no, and I'm just gonna throw it out there. Tommy gonna tiptoe around it, I ain't. Y'all stole their land, straight up. Y'all the one that tricked them in Thanksgiving. Yeah, I heard the stories, you know what I'm saying? The pilgrims and stuff, y'all did them dirty. That wasn't us. We cool with the Indians.
Towards white folks. After all, many tribes have a similar story. European immigrants landed on their shores, starving and close to death, and many natives offered their help to help these pilgrims survive. In fact, our national holiday of Thanksgiving celebrates this very hospitality. Now, I know I simplified the beginning between the two groups, but what eventually followed were things like enslavement, frequent bloody battles, natives getting pushed from the land they had known for centuries, and smallpox wiping out 90% of the native population.
Ignorant.
Now, this isn't to say that the original Americans would have lived in some paradise world if it wasn't for the European settlers. The truth is, many tribes warred with each other, massacred each other, they massacred many settlers, and native warriors had some ugly practices like scalping their enemies.
Oh my god!
No matter the conflict, things can get ugly when there are battles over resources, personal freedom, and valuable territory. It's just how humans are. But all things considered, Indians got the sharp end of the stick when dealing with the Europeans. They experienced numerous atrocities at the hands of people like Christopher Columbus and Andrew Jackson. But more on this later. We don't have time for me to ramble about history all day, so let's get into the people that we are meeting today. In this episode, we dive into the Gila River Reservation and see what life is like for the people from the Pima and Maricopa tribes. These people have had their fair share of battles ranging from water right disputes with the U.S. government to fighting things in the community like obesity and drug addiction. But they've also triumphed on major levels. They've scored massive infrastructure deals with the government, as well as had fantastic success with their casinos. Enough of the talk.
Where is this? Did I miss that part? What? I heard him say the Gila something, but where is that located? So I know where not to go. I'm just asking because, you know, we asking questions, but he ain't giving me the right information.
Talk for now. Let's get into the episode.
Gila Reservation. California, maybe?
In the first part of this journey, we are welcomed into the home of Grandma Sandra, a town staple who cooks for us and tells us about the culture and community. Here we go.
I'm Tommy.
Sandy.
Nice to meet you.
What land are we on right now?
We're on the Gila River.
Can you tell me any of the history of this place?
The Pima is called Acamil Atum. That's the name of our people. And we've been here from the very beginning. In fact, our land is in Phoenix, the whole area.
Oh, Phoenix.
We're related to the Hohokam tribe. The white folks came, all the tribes got put on reservations. And this is our reservation that we have now.
I'm gonna give everyone their first reading assignment so far in the channel. There's a book called Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee that everyone should read.
Imagine for a moment that the Chinese began taking over America and that the way they made peace with us was by forcing us to sign treaties that removed us from the wonderful land we grew up on and forced us to move to the shittiest areas they could find. Places
wow.
where crops can barely grow and the resources are slim. And on top of that, the minor concessions they did offer to us in the treaties, shortly after, they would break their word and go back on their promise. Let's take the Sioux people in Nebraska, for example. Once the U.S. government found out that the land that they stayed on had valuable gold mines, they again pushed them to a new and even shittier parcel of land. This is what tribes across
the country... That's ignorant, bro. First of all, you already bogus for pushing me out the land I was originally at. And then I get pushed to this new land and I end up discovering something good. And you'd be like, oh, wait. Nah, we don't want y'all to have that. Let me push you somewhere else. What? I'm not gonna lie. Y'all gotta see me. We gonna have to fight it out. Yeah, like, I'm not going. Especially if it's gold under my feet that I found. And you just come in and talk about, that's my gold. No, I didn't sign no paper that said that. I signed the paper that said, this is my land now. You can have our old land. We gonna get moved to this new land. I signed that treaty and it was already spit in my face. You know what I'm saying? I just let it roll with the punches because, you know, I ain't want no war. I'm trying to be peaceful. But I end up finding this new land. And I get here and find something special and make the land nice. And you come over here talking about, no, we want this too. I'm not going to lie. I'll spit in your face.
Wow. In their dealings with the U.S. government over the mid-1800s. To best understand the treachery of this period, I recommend you read the book, Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee. I read this book in college and what I learned has stuck with me ever since. This book is linked in my description.
I don't really be reading like that, I ain't gonna lie.
Free health, well, this state. I lived in Virginia and they don't have it there. And they might now, but my family has land here. We cause any problems, we could get kicked off our reservation. The casinos brought in a lot of money for us.
How does that work? Does every person that lives here have a share in the casino? Because I've been in Seminole country where I think it's over 18, all of the kids get a certain monthly sum from the casino.
Oh.
Yes, ours is every 3 months. And when they turn 18, they'll get their money.
Are there any benefits or perks living in the tribe? Like you were saying, free health care.
Well, this tribe here helps you pay your electricity. We don't pay water bill. We don't pay rent. We don't get taxed for our land.
Let's talk about free housing in this area.
Okay.
From what I understand, when a tribal member comes of age, they will be built a house free of charge, and the size of the house will depend on how big their family is. Additionally, upon turning 18, this person will also receive a lump sum of between $50,000 and $100,000 to kickstart their adult life. And for supplemental income for everyone on the Gila River Reservation, children and adults, they each receive a quarterly stipend ranging from $350 to $650. Now, this country has had a long-standing debate if these practices help or hurt a community. You guys tell me what you think in the comments.
We're having a Thanksgiving dinner right now, too.
Is that a complicated holiday to celebrate?
You know, I grew up in foster care, and I never knew none of my family until I turned 25. When I turned 25, I came to look for my family. I found my mom and my dad. My mother's from here, the tribe, and my dad's from the Tonawatam tribe. And when I...
I don't know about that one. I'm thinking, like, she was in foster care because her parents, you know what I'm saying, they, unfortunate circumstances, they passed away or something. But no, they just didn't want her. They said, go to foster care, you know, and maybe when you come back, I'll accept you.
Huh?
I'm not gonna lie, I'm not going back to see you. Like, man, no, I can't even say that because I'm not even in that position. You know, I feel like they still want to meet their parents. But did she just let that slide? Like, she been in the foster care system since she was a little girl and now she's a grown adult. Now they want to be like, oh, I'm your mommy, your daddy. I'm not going to lie. That's not how it's going to go.
Found out about that. I was so happy. And they both tribes accepted me without no doubt. I never grew up here, but I've been living here now for over like 40 years, 45 years.
Oh, wow.
I did get to meet my mom, but I never got to meet my father. You could only pick one tribe to be enrolled in. And I picked my father's side because I never got to meet him and I wanted something from him. And so I picked that tribe. But I've always lived on this tribe, in the Pima tribe.
Something extra was telling us in the car that I wanted to ask you about is that there's kind of myth or rumors of spirits in the mountains or portals. Have you ever heard anything like that?
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah. Have you ever heard of anyone going missing or like talking to the mountain spirits and think bad things happen?
One of my uncles, he does go up there a lot, and he says he always sees stuff, different things.
Like what the heck?
Away from the mountain, and he makes it all
this. The symbol of the guy with the flute, that is the fertility god, isn't
it?
It worked for me, folks. Within a 1 week of trying with my wife, we got pregnant. How would you describe this place to someone that's never been here before?
They still go by the old ways, you know. Some people still cook with wood, but now they're building houses for the people out here, so they're getting new houses. They're still building houses now for the casino, you know.
The casino money flows through.
Yeah.
How do you feel about our government?
I think they're kind of crooked, you know. They take a lot of money from us. The casino is built on our land. We built it, but they still tax. You know, a lot of people out here, they're either on drugs or drinking, you know, because they don't have no kind of income, nowhere to go.
They're on drugs
what
and drinking?
People you think have a drug issue around here?
80%, maybe.
That's high. Is there a good hospital or is there a good amount of medical staff in the area that help with people?
Yeah, they got a drug rehab out here, but, you know, very few people go through it.
On the 24th, I have 24 years of sobriety.
Wow.
For about 18 years, I did the Kamake AANA group here in our district. That's why I never grew up here on the reservation, because my mom and my dad were both alcoholics and they couldn't take care of them. And so
okay.
I grew up in foster care. It's been awful.
Why is it you think the alcohol...
Alright, I understand now. I don't think I would hold a grudge like that either then. If, you know what I'm saying, they had trouble with alcohol and stuff and, you know, they had to take time to give me a better life and just fix themselves first. I wouldn't hold a grudge back then. I recount my statement from the beginning talking about that ain't my mama no more. No, that's still gonna be my mom.
A strong pull here.
People can't figure out how to be happy being clean and sober. And we're all related. If we look at it that way, we'll all get along.
I don't know. I don't get along with my siblings all the time.
About how long do you go on each side?
Really fast. A minute. Not even a minute. As soon as this grease is hot, it gets it cooked fast.
Kinda what like is
a
that?
Tortilla almost.
Yeah. So this is my dough. This is the flour most natives use, the bluebird. I'm trying to teach my family, my girls, or anybody who wants to know how to do it so they can carry it on.
How many of y'all got family recipes?
Break into this shit.
So there's a lot of banners around here?
Oh, hell yeah. See, this part of the security right here.
Oh, look, someone discarded a toilet right there. If I had to shit and I came across that, I'd be disappointed.
People go up there.
People climb all the way up there?
Yeah.
Have you been up there?
No, I haven't been up there.
I'm kind of scared of heights.
Yeah, I'm scared of heights though.
There's some owls, these shapeshifters.
Basically, it's an old human spirit or something.
Yeah, this used to be her little outhouse. I mean, this is where they used to sell fried bread.
What happened?
Shit, just time, people getting locked up. She didn't really have much people to help her. So this is what's left of it now.
I hear the dust storm comes. It just comes right over that mountain. Everything up.
Dust storm. Oh!
It can come whenever.
It's usually like one good dust storm a year.
Yeah, it's a couple.
That's the red chili.
And pulled pork?
No, this is beef.
This is over 100 years old.
Yes.
How long do you think this took to make?
Oh, probably a long time.
Days?
Yes.
These are also over 100
they're
years old.
They're old too.
There's something special about handmade.
Okay, is he supposed to be touching that?
The Navajo taco, all the tribes make that, and it's just beans, hamburger, cheese, lettuce, tomatoes, and that's a...
Really good. Thank you. This is going to be such a gringo question, but I don't eat the husk, right?
No. You can if you want.
I didn't mean to embarrass myself. But. Yeah. Good. Well, Grandma Sandra, you filled our bellies. We appreciate you for that.
You. Next stop, the circles.
They blocked off the playground? Yeah. Why do they do that?
Because there'd be a lot of kids. These motherfuckers go hang out right there, and then they'd just be crazy.
Are these abandoned? Are people living?
It's abandoned right here, look.
Do you think anyone's living in there?
Probably.
So are there gang affiliations around here?
Yeah, it's by zones. I think this is zone 6. People around here be like, man, I couldn't find no pills, so I started smoking meth.
What?
Has Fetty Wap made it?
Why does he say that? Like the pills was a good... Oh my God! Like the pills pills was a good alternative. He said they couldn't find no pills, so they turned to meth. I'm like, what the heck? Why didn't y'all stick to the pills? What is he talking about? Why are you on pills in the first place? Meth is crazy too, though. I understand both sides. You know, both sides are dirty. I think I'd rather be on pills than meth, I guess, if I had to pick one, because, you know, the meth heads be looking crazy. Teeth be falling out. I wish my teeth would fall out because I'm doing drugs. But anyway, like, why are these people out here doing drugs? Why is there gangs? Like, I guess we're gonna find out.
We're in the circles, which is called a project. This is mostly where everybody lives, I guess. Back in the day, there was a lot of gangs out here. There's still gangs out here now. Back in the day, it was pretty crazy.
You grew up around here?
Yeah, I grew up over here. There was just a lot of shootings, a lot of people dying from shootings, you know. The airbag was out here a lot. There's still gangs out here now, but they're a lot younger, you know.
What's the relationship with police around here?
They don't really do their job around here. There's a lot of murders that haven't been solved. A lot of people have been out here and they never find anybody who did it.
Is this a place where people feel comfortable to call the police when something goes down?
Not so much, I guess. It's a small community, so people know people and they'll know if you call the police on them.
Is there anything you can tell the people about the circles?
Don't come through here and not if you don't know nobody. What? Talk around here.
Don't come through here is crazy.
But this has been here for ages.
Local
this
church.
This is an old boarding school. Back in the day, my mom was in a boarding school here. She was small all the way to 13 when she came out of the boarding school. She don't really talk about it. I asked her. She just gets quiet, so. And they did a lot of, you know, the molesting and all that. Some
oh my God.
Died, you know, in their hands.
It's crazy how much child molestation the Catholic Church has gotten away with.
Yeah.
We have got to talk about Indian boarding schools. These places were awful. In 1819, the Civilization Fund Act was passed with the intent to civilize natives and assimilate them to Anglo-Saxon culture. The stated purpose of this act was to kill the Indian and save the man. And in doing so, a few hundred schools were created and ran by the Catholics and other Christian denominations.
Rewind on the play. No disrespect to anybody's religion, any priest out there, but if you're one of those priests that do them weird things to kids, you are ignorant. I think your priest badge needs to be snatched away because what's wrong with you? You're supposed to be like the messenger for God. God's supposed to be talking through you and you doing this weird stuff. Come on, bro. How you gonna preach to me and not follow your own preaching? What the heck? What is that? You're just evil at this point.
Bruh.
Like, what's wrong with you? Why would you do that? Like, I remember watching this one video where the priest was doing something weird to this underage girl that was a part of the church, and she had grew up and had been scared to talk about it because she was scared of what would happen, and you know how that go. And she ended up speaking about it, and before she could speak about it, he, like, took it upon himself to be like, oh, yeah, I'm resigning. And he didn't tell the full story. He said he was resigning because the devil had got to him or whatever. He didn't really tell, like, the full story. He kind of just made it seem like, oh, he needed to do some self-searching. But no, the girl stood up and was like, hey, you said you were going to tell everybody what happened. No, what really happened was da-da-da-da-da. He did this with me when I was 16 and 15 and 14. She was telling all this stuff. I think these people are, like, I think it's kind of hypocritical and ignorant of them.
And other Christian denominations. Hundreds of thousands of kids were forcibly removed from their home and in the loving name of Jesus. These Christian schools doled out beatings, forced labor, sexual abuse, and a complete crushing of native culture to these kids.
Ignorant.
With rulers, whips, and sticks as their tools of choice, nuns relentlessly played whack-a-mole on their native students. And if hell exists, these nuns are certainly there, and I hope Satan is playing whack-a-mole on them. And if this imagery isn't enough to infuriate you, imagine if the Taliban took over your town, took you from your parents, and beat the dog shit out of you at their schools until you converted to their version of Islam.
Furious.
That would be insane. And that's what this was like. And folks, I'm proud to be an American. 100%. But it's undeniable that we have some despicably ugly chapters of our past. And the best
for real
way to avoid
slavery?
Making similar
no!
mistakes in the future is to study and learn from history.
What does religion mean to you?
Just going to church, you know, just going by the Bible, doing good. My mom will bring us out here on the weekends and during the summer. So, like,
I went to church in Phoenix a lot. I didn't really come to church out here. Just when I got older, I came to church out here.
I noticed you're wearing the Blackhawk hockey team.
Yeah.
Chicago Blackhawks.
A professional sports team has a Native American as their logo.
I don't really have a problem with it, but a lot of natives do.
Could you imagine if they made a football team called the Whiteskins?
Yeah, I heard about that. I used to have a red skin hat. You know, I didn't know nothing about it at the time. It was just a little beanie. I think I got it from like Burlington or something. Just something to keep my head warm. I don't really know about it. And apparently it was just some big uproar. And I can see how, you know, like if they really feel like that's disrespect for them, I respect it. I won't wear a hat no more. I actually can't even find that hat.
Symbol in the middle.
That's the man in the maze. That's our Pima's symbol.
That's a good symbol for life.
Yeah.
I think we all feel pretty lost throughout life.
Yeah.
Sometimes you feel like you know where you're going, but for the most part, it's like, where the hell am I, right? So Grandma's taking us in the mountains right now. She wants to show us some things.
The mountains?
Come out here and dump stuff over here.
What?
There's been a lot of bodies found, not here, but over in another section of the res.
This was now the third person that had mentioned something about people going missing and bodies being discovered at the reservation. In fact, a Google search will tell you that another body was found on the Gila River Reservation as recently as January of this year.
Wow.
If you take a closer look at this trend, you'll discover that bodies have been discovered on reservations in Montana, Wisconsin, New Jersey, all in the early months of 2024. I even got a DM in January about this happening on a reservation in Winnipeg, Canada. It's worrisome how many women on reservations go missing or end up murdered. A study from 2008 showed that Native women get murdered at a rate that's 10 times higher than what's usual across the country. What's more, most—
Who is doing this? Why are y'all killing women? What's wrong with y'all? Now when we just like stuck at a standstill, it's just a bunch of dudes sitting around talking about, oh, wait, we can't have kids. Look, oh, humanity is over with. We gonna be looking dumb. Why are y'all killing women? I'm not advocating for killing, period, but dude, 10 times? 10 times the rate? Come on, bro, I ain't gonna lie. That is foul, and they dumping their bodies in the mountain and stuff. It's some really crazy people around here, huh?
Most of these cases don't even make it to the Department of Justice's missing person list. And get this, murder is the third most common way that Native women die, even more so than strokes,
wow,
liver problems, or diabetes. So it begs the question, why is this happening? And from what I can gather, there are two main factors. Number one, local law enforcement does not have jurisdiction to police a Native reservation. Instead, the reservation has its own police force regulated by the Bureau of Indian Affairs. For some killers, reservations are opportunistic places where they feel they have a better chance of getting away with their crimes. Combine that with the fact that natives overall tend to not want to talk or cooperate with police, and you find yourself in an environment where murders are really hard to solve.
Myself, I used to come up here, drive all the way up there. There's a road you can take, but it's been a long time. And I had a four-wheel drive truck, and I used to go up there and party up there,
yeah,
drinking and get high and all that.
Yeah.
What the heck?
How far is it off-road?
Far. It goes all the way to Mexico. There's a back road. They used to go deliver drugs.
Really?
Yeah.
Grandma's starting to take us on a crazy adventure. Bodies, stolen car, trafficking to Mexico.
Who grandma is this?
Dude, you want to be out here?
How is she doing this?
Oh no.
Oh no, oh, no grandma.
Car.
This is a bad idea.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Jesus.
Sorry to say I'm not as tough as you are. I got a little scared when you were hitting those trails. I thought I was gonna get stuck. So I wanna hear more about the bodies, cause you just casually said that, and I feel like I wanna touch on that a little bit more.
A lot of people come from Phoenix, and because we're so far out here, and there's nothing over here, I mean, you know, so people come and dump bodies here.
You can tell this is a drinking town, look at this.
Is that glass?
30, 40 feet off the road, and still, like it just shines, the road is shining. Yeah, this is definitely a drink in town.
Next, we make a stop at Big Mike's house. He's a religious leader. He has a sweat lodge set up in his own backyard, and he has stories for days.
Is he blind?
Let's knock on his door and see what he has to say.
This is Big Mike's house. We're heading towards his sweat lodge. He's helped me a lot. We fought against the Interstate 202 now.
And why didn't people want it here?
And we like natural. All natives like that. It's not on our land. It's on the other side. But it might as well be. It's right there, right on the border of our tribe. They even cut the mountain. That was our sacred mountain where we go and pray and stuff.
I read that 50% of people around here have diabetes. Is that something that you're familiar with?
Yes.
Or that?
Yes, it's real bad here.
I'm not gonna lie. It was probably them tacos. Oh. I don't want to say nothing. I was looking at them like, dang. that doesn't look healthy. But hey, I was like, oh, maybe that's part of their culture. But diabetes is crazy. I'm not gonna lie. If I'm not gonna be healthy after I eat it, I don't know if I'm gonna eat it. You know what I mean? That looked like a big thing of grease.
Bruh. We weren't allowed to do our traditional ways. We had to learn to be like them.
Is there still a long-standing resentment towards Europeans or white culture?
Yeah, that's what everybody though.
The people that had to live through it, they know.
I think it's more horrible than people could imagine. I don't think people know history that well, but if people do their digging and they research how awful it was.
How America was, we weren't free to roam like we should have been.
We were slaves!
Good evening.
What's he saying?
Good evening, my name is Michael Tashquint. My traditional last name is from my great-grandfather, Tashquint. I'm here in the village of Komot. Southwest is what they call the Astoria Mountains, but to us, we call it Komot Doak. Komot Doak means thick mountain.
You had 28 years sobriety.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
What made you start that journey?
93, I lost my brother up the road here. He got hit. We were going up to go get some more beer and everything like that. We're coming back, and we were just coming up the road here. Just on the other side, there were those houses on that side. Begin, this people hit a horse. You know, the woman you could see where she hit the windshield. Her face is all bloody. As we were going by, the door on the driver's side was open, and there was a guy laying on it. So I told my cousin, you know, pull up behind him. They pulled up behind. My brother already jumped out, and he ran over there. Just when I got out, I heard my brother go to the other side, and he was checking on the woman. And I heard my cousin yelling out, Chris, look out, there's a car coming. And then next thing I know, my brother was standing with the door here and he was waving his hands like this. Well, they missed the car, but they hit him right there and it just went over him and everything like that. I got out of the back seat of the car and I just turned and I looked and I seen him get hit his head and brains, blood and everything like that. And I was over him like this, I was laying on top of him like this, and I kept telling him, you know, don't leave me, I need you. You're the one that's holding my leash. My brother was the guy, more or less controlled me.
If
I was
gonna
kick somebody's ass, he would say, go kick their ass. And I say, really? And I go over there and kick their ass. I ended up getting deep into drugs. I didn't give a shit about anybody. The final point came was that one night, I guess we were sitting there drinking and everything like that. And I was sitting there rolling up joints, sprinkling with coke, like that, and rolling them up to get ready to smoke. And after that, I got sick. I mean, I almost died. And that's what kind of snapped me out of it. Whatever happened to me, my dad, my brother came.
I remember that's
going
God.
I mean, you know how the lights are on top of us? And I remember looking up like that and watching like that. And I just seen him going, choo, 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 choo. That's, I was out. And I just woke up and I said, what the hell? And then the nurse came around and she goes, oh, you're awake, you're back. I said, what? And then she goes, you know, what day is this? I said, Wednesday evening. And she looked at me, she goes, no. She goes, this is Saturday evening.
You've been out
for the last 3 days. Your family's about ready to bring in the priest to give you last rites because you weren't going to make it. I said, what? She goes, yeah, we're about ready to die. I remember I started walking and I was going in something like gray. It was just all gray. And all of a sudden, out of this side, I seen this black figure come out like that, you know.
Is he blind?
My brother started laughing. He goes, what are you doing here? You don't belong here. It's not your time. On the other side, I seen another figure on this side. My dad, I heard his voice. This is not your time, he said. You need to go back. Come on, we'll take you back. And as they were coming back, they started telling me about sobering up, changing my life, doing the things I needed to do.
Woke
up.
Wow.
That's how after.
Y'all know what's crazy? This dude didn't have this whole premonition thing while he was out. Meanwhile, I can't remember my dream from last night.
Oh!
Like, ain't that crazy? Is this something wrong with me or does everybody have trouble with that? Because I feel like some people be telling their stories like about their dreams and it be like specific details to a T, like a whole storytelling time. Like, they just boom, put it all out there. I'm like missing bits and pieces. I'm like, oh, wait, hold on. That's not what happened, is it? I'd be confused. It'd be like a vague and vivid, and I don't know if I used the right words, but I said them.
That's when I decided I gotta quit. So they took me and sent me down to chemo, and that's when I found out I had PTSD.
It feels like this world is losing its soul and losing its culture a little bit. Can you speak to that from your lens?
I can understand that, and I know what you're talking about, because our young kids, they're not picking it up. They don't know too much about the history and the culture of our people, especially grandparents that went to boarding school. In the boarding schools, they were stripped of their identity, their hair was cut, they were forbidden to speak the language. A lot of elders are embarrassed or ashamed to speak the language to their children and tell them the stories and all of that. Growing up here, my family made me understand who I am. They made me speak English first. But I asked them, why'd you teach me English first? They said, because if you learn Pima, it would be hard for you to learn English. And from there, my grandparents and family helped, you know, raise me and teach me my traditions. So trying to keep that up to the kids now. A lot of kids, they just don't know.
White man society. What comes to mind when you think of that phrase?
The coming of the Europeans, from the Spanish coming through the islands, Puerto Rico, you know, Cuba, from there establishing their ports and everything like that, and then from there coming across to Mexico, South America, enslaving the indigenous people, all for gold, silver, and land, and everything else like that. Then again, too, the Europeans, the French, the English, the Dutch, they say, were the only people that kind of took care of the native peoples. But when you look into the history of the English, Spanish, and the French, they stole, they conquered, they lied, they paid for the bounties of scalps.
That's weird. Spanish,
French, English, women, children, elders. Thing about the border, they talk about all the people that are from Mexico and on that way. Those are indigenous people. Even the Mexicans. That's not the right word for Mexico. It's Mexica. That's the thing about the white man society, the Europeans coming here and just trying to make us and totally assimilate us.
What are some spiritual beliefs of this land?
When the son married, he brought his wife home. If the sister married, she married out of the family.
What are the biggest challenges facing this community?
We're doing good. I can't really say anything wrong or anything bad. Through the casino revenues, the tribe is taken care of. There's money through the gaming compact that goes to all seven districts here. That money helps take care of, you know.
Like, what kind of benefits do tribal members receive from the casino?
Nothing really from the casino. The only thing you get is just the per cap that we get every month. I mean, every 4 months, every quarterly. But like I was saying,
Same for everybody, or does it change by age, or how do they?
No, it's the same. It's the same. It's set at one set amount, but it's different. Each quarterly is different, depending on what these casinos make. My first house.
So do they work, or do they have to work? And I'm pretty sure they would still have to work, right? Because I don't think that's enough to live off of. But they say they don't got to pay for rent, housing. And when you turn 18, you just get a house and you get a jump start, $100,000. Like, I mean, I don't know. That just seems like confused. And I feel like I missed something in there. That something don't seem right. That seemed like too good to be true. It got to be something else going on. Unless, like, the houses they getting, maybe the houses are boo-boo or trash. Maybe that's, like, what's wrong. But I don't know. Okay, that doesn't sound too bad to me. Like, I'm looking at it from perspective of, you know, my life right now. And as soon as I turned 18, I got me a house, a bunch of money, you know, and then just a set amount, just the rest of my life, I guess. I would still work, though, I think. I don't know.
My mom and dad built themselves. Second house, the Bureau of Indian Affairs built that for me. Then this one is the tribe built that for me. And again, it's in the gaming compact that homes are supposed to be provided for all enrolled tribal members.
Final thoughts you have, or anything you would like to say to the audience out there?
I just turned 70. I go to the gym all the time. I wanted to do with my wife to go in there and put it on our Facebook. Here I am, my birthday, 70 years old, still working out, you know. Come on in and come work out with me. Diabetes is a very, very high thing here on my reservation.
And from what I saw with the numbers, it's over half?
Yeah. At one time, I was like close to 800 pounds. Right now, I'm probably bouncing between 320 and 290 maybe. Since you're finishing up and you're getting ready to go home, this is called the Going Home Song. Hey, I'm in
Yadobim. And with that, folks, thank you for joining us on this adventure. We'll see you next week.
Hey, I'm in Yadobim. Hey, I'm in Yadobim.
I'm not laughing at the song. I promise you, I'm not laughing at the song. I'm laughing at the way Tommy is looking right now, bro.
Oh my God!
You know when there's something serious going on in the classroom and you look at your friend and you just start laughing because they got the dumbest look on their face, bro. It's one of those situations. I just looked at them and I couldn't hold it in. Oh my God. But I don't know, man. What y'all think about this whole Indian reservation thing? Like, do y'all think it's fair that they had to be pushed to these places? Like, I don't know. Like, I mean, like, some, like, it didn't seem, like, all just bad. It seemed like it got its pros and its cons, like, with anything. But, I mean, like, that whole thing back in the day, like, with the Europeans and white folk and the white culture and stuff. Like, yeah, the white people have problems with a lot of people and then still got the nerve to act like, oh, well, it was that long ago. Well, what do you want us to do about it? Like, you know, I just feel like a lot of times they don't feel sorry for it. And I'm not talking about all white people. I'm talking about some white people that are still racist to this day, still feel like the world should be like that to this day, still feel entitled to their rights, feel like they got some type of superiority over another individual just because of the skin, the color of their skin. You know, I think that's kind of weird. I have problems with those type of white people, but not saying all white people are like that. Like, it's some good white people out there, like Tommy G, that's a good white person. He's sitting there taking the time to listen to their story and reflect on it and be like, yeah, that was wrong. You know, I don't know, but that's just how I feel. So y'all let me know how y'all feel in the comments, man. How do y'all feel about the Indian reservations? Let me know down below. And y'all know, dude, y'all just did too much to subscribe. We're gonna go to 10,000 subscribers, and just hit that like button if you like the video. I don't know. It just makes sense to hit the like button if you like the video. Even if you didn't like it, just still hit it. It don't cost nothing. It's free. White people, y'all better stop with this ignorance. We gone. We'll be right back.